Brethren, hold on to the word of God. Amen. And God will see you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, give those hands together for the Lord. Daniel chapter 9, verse 2. In the first year of his reign, Darius, I, Daniel, understood by the books the numbers of years specified by the word of the Lord through Jeremiah, the prophet, that it would accomplish 70 years in the desolation of Jerusalem. The New International Bible says, I, Daniel, understood from the scriptures, according to the word of the Lord given to Jeremiah the prophet. All scripture is given by the inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. The scripture is the word of God spoken and inspired by God, spoken through men, inspired by God. All scripture, brothers and sisters, all scripture is inspired by God. So this title is All Scripture. I, Daniel, understood from the scriptures that the desolation of Jerusalem will last 70 years. Verse 3. So I turned to the Lord God, and pleaded with him in prayer and petition, in fasting and in sackcloth and ashes. When he got to know the plan of God through the books, he was spurred into action to pray, to seek the face of God and to intercede, to confess his sins and the sins of his nation. All scripture is inspired by God. The scriptures is the plan of God for mankind. And for you, you want to know the plan of God for you. If you really want to know the plan of God for you, it's in the scriptures. What God planned for you is there. So Daniel was taken into captivity, into slavery, let's call it the way we understand it today. And he grew up in that situation. Even though he was as a slave, or he was given an opulent treatment because he was in the palace of the king. Yet, he did not forsake God, and God did not forsake him. He remembered God. It was this same Daniel that was put in the lion's den, remember. And even in the lion's den, it was then that God remembered him, and God brought him out of the dead. But God is faithful. We will not allow you to suffer more than what you can bear, but will, with the temptation, provide the way of escape. Everyone say the way of escape.
The way of escape.
There is the way of escape that only God can provide. So whatever situation you are, let's trust God. Talk to somebody and say, God is faithful.
God is faithful.
Yes, at times we might not understand why. You may not know how, you may not know when, but he will do it again.
Yes.
We might not know how, we may not know when, but God is faithful.
Amen.
All scripture. What you learn from the scripture, what you learn from scripture is yours to keep. It's yours for inheritance. And Daniel not understood the scriptures, he would not have known how long it would take Jerusalem in the desolation. So he understood by the books. I'm telling you, there are so many things you will need to understand through the word of God about your life. And until you begin to be the student of the scriptures, you might still not discover it. You don't need a prophet to tell you some things about your life, because they have already been foretold in the word of God. Had Daniel not understood the scriptures, he would not have known how long the desolation would take. So I turned to God and pleaded with him in prayer. It's good to hear the story of other people. Well, what about your own story? Do you know that you also have a story? To tell people about God, you don't need to be reminded. So I turned to God and pleaded with him in prayer. If you knew the scriptures, brothers and sisters, it will inspire you to act differently. The scriptures will inspire you to pray. Say, I understood by the books, and then I turned to the Lord and prayed to God. Verse 20. Now while I was speaking, praying, and confessing my sin, three things he was doing. That tells you that your prayer, you need to vocalize it. Because you are going through stuff, and God is interested in what you are going through. We do not have a high priest that is not touched by the feelings of our infirmities. But who at all points was tempted, but he did not sin. So whatever you are going through, he has gone ahead of you. And because he has gone ahead of you, he will make the way for you.
Amen.
Now while I was speaking, praying, and confessing my sin and the sin of my people Israel. That's a point there. Don't just pray. You will need to confess your sin as well. Because the things you have done, he said the sin lies at the door. His desire is to what? Catch you. But you must rule over it. So every time we stand in prayer, those sins are there if you have not confessed them. So you need to address them. I don't think that God did not see them. Because for many people, they are not going forward. Why? Because the sin lies at the door. Even the sin itself is the one preventing them from going forward. Say, he that confesses his sin shall what?
Prosper.
What about he that did not confess his sin? So don't just pray, you will need to confess your sin as well. There are things in life troubling us, and they can only be destroyed when we confess our sins. Verse 21. Yes, while I was speaking in prayer, the man Gabriel, whom I had seen in the vision at the beginning, being caused to fly swiftly, reached me about the time of the evening offering. Who was that? An angel. You never knew that as people were giving testimonies here, you didn't see the angels, they were all here. But the angels were the messengers of the blessing. They are the ones that brought the blessing for the people to testify. The gift you got was brought by the angel. The angel inspired the people to do it. And because he knows that when you do it, something will come to you yourself. Amen?
Amen.
So there are angels in the house. So if you do the same thing you are doing in the church, in your house, there are angels there as well.
Amen.
Yes, while I was speaking in prayer, the man Gabriel, whom I had seen in the vision at the beginning, being caused to fly swiftly, reached me, 22, and informed me and talked with me, and said, "Oh, Daniel, I have now come forth to give you skill to understand." See, one thing led to another. Starting from the scripture, he understood by the scripture, isn't it? He understood the plan of God. Then, what did he do? He spoke prayed and confessed his sin, so he stood in the gap. He interceded, isn't it? For the people and for himself, isn't it? Then the moment he began to speak in prayer and confess his sins and the sins of the people, from that moment on, what did God do? God sent his angel. Could you be missing out, therefore, from the blessing God meant for you if you don't understand the scriptures? Could you be missing out? Is it possible to be suffering for food in the presence of food?
Yes,
it's
possible. We
counsel. Diabetes, isn't it? Spiritual diabetes. Not that there's no food, but it's not getting into itself. So it's possible to be in the presence of God, yet you are not reaching out to God. Even though it was the plan of God to reach out to you. So what is the disconnect? Sin. And this is what sin does in people's lives. Sin will obstruct you from blessings until you confess it. Sin is a stain. If the pastor sins, it's just a matter of time. He will die and will flow. He will go back to give account of what is his son. And that will be judged the same way you are judged. So every one of us go by the books. Every one of us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All scripture. Psalm 119, verse 144. David said, or the writer of that particular verse, chapter said, "Give me understanding, and I shall live." The Amplified translation says, your righteous testimonies are everlasting, and your decrees are binding to eternity. Give me understanding, and I shall live. Give me discernment and comprehension, and I shall not die. If somebody comes to you and says you are going to die, it's going to make you afraid. Why? Because you don't know what the scripture says. But inside the scripture it says, "I shall not die, but I shall live to declare the glory of God." Except we are declaring the glory of God, that is the reason God has given you extended life.
Amen.
If you are not going to declare the glory of God, there is no point in you living. Hello? Give me understanding and I shall live. Give me discernment and comprehension and I shall not die.
Yes.
Regardless of doctor's diagnosis, you will not die.
Amen.
If you know what it takes for you not to die.
Yes.
If you took time out, therefore, to understand the scriptures, you will not be afraid of dying. If you understand the plan of God from scripture, you will not be afraid of death. After all, to live is Christ.
Die is gain.
That is gain. He said to live is Christ. What am I living for?
Christ.
Christ, not for British style. I'm telling you. Because if I mention Naira now, people say, well, what are you saying? Naira is the currency in Nigeria.
Yes, yes.
So which one is better now?
Naira.
Don't let us go there. So to live is Christ. To die is gain. So when I'm living, I need to be doing the will of God so that I can give me an extension. And once I have finished my work, then I'm ready to go. Because I have invested in heaven. Said, I have gone to prepare a place for you. If it were not so, I would have told you. John 14, 1. So do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God, but also believe in me. God is not a liar. So through the scriptures we understand that death is actually a gain for the true believer. And not dying is to do the will of God here on earth and bring others to God through your lifestyle. And that's exactly what I was telling you. That's the opportunity we have. I'm looking for that opportunity as well. I'm not looking for people everywhere I go. You know, there are many things you will not know outside the scripture. So it is through the scripture that you can find out. But the moment you begin to cite the scriptures, many of the things that make others afraid. You heard that testimony of a woman. That what happened to her, many people have even died before death. You know, some people die before the death comes. That's why David said, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall not fear. Why? Because I know the Lord is with me. His rod and thy staff comfort me. Brothers and sisters, God is with us. Even in the mess. Was it not him that was with Daniel in the den? What about the three Hebrew children? In the furnace of fire. Excuse me, has anybody been in the furnace of fire before?
No.
Somebody came to me and said, Pastor, this place is getting hot. Can we reduce it? Can we switch up the radiator? It was only the radiator you reacted to. What about the furnace of fire? The people there, they were there. They were ready to risk their life. And they did. But the fourth man was there.
Yes.
And looked at him.
Yeah.
I only sent three people there, but there was fourth one there. So even in your mess, God is there in your mess. Yeah. Hallelujah! Can you hear?
Yeah.
You think we're alone?
No.
You are God alone. What time began? You are on the throne. You are God alone. I am right now. In the good times and bad. Coming on. Let's get this right now. Hallelujah. So there are things you will begin to discover about yourself when you begin to search the scripture. The Bereans in Acts chapter 17, let's look at it, verse 11. The Bereans searched the scriptures, and I want you to be like the Bereans. Said these were more fear-minded. Are you with me? Honorable. Those than those in Thessalonica. Why? In that they received the word with all readiness. Everyone say readiness.
Readiness.
What is the point of God speaking to you when you know, when he knows you are not ready for it? That's why God stopped talking to some people. Why? Because the last time, the last thing he said to you, you haven't done it. And you want God to speak again.
No.
Do you think God wastes his word?
No.
No. Judge for yourself. If you have said that I've not heard from God for long, ask yourself. The last one he said, did I do? What did I do? That. And God speaks to youth now. He speaks to children. He bypasses the old one. And then he speaks to the young one. In the house of Prophet Eli, the old one, there was a boy called Samuel. He spoke to Samuel. He spoke to Samuel. And he used the adult to now interpret what he has said. So every one of us, we are useful.
Amen.
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 They cite the scriptures. How often? Daily. Do you do that? And it's not just for you to glance. It didn't say glance. They search. In other words, they were studious. They wanted to know. They were ready. Some families don't pray together. Some families don't even study the Bible together. But they are not here.
Amen.
Yes.
And even if you are here, just know that God, Pastor wants you also to study the Bible.
Amen.
And God also wants you to study the scripture. So there are discoveries awaiting your discovery about you when you study the Bible. As you daily search the scriptures to find out the truth, you will make a discovery of yourself. We have, as a church, we have 3D mission statement: discovery, discipleship, and deployment. Until you can discover yourself, then you make a recovery of your losses. And then when you have made a recovery of your losses, you bounce back. Then you now begin to be discipled by God. Isn't it? And then after you have been discipled, say, follow me and I shall make you fishers of men. And then you cannot be deployed. That is, know where you fit in. Turn somebody and say, you fit in somewhere. Yes. God has sent you to help the person sitting next to you as the body of Christ. That is the reason why we are here.
Amen.
You think you know, but you still don't know. You cannot know until you search for it. And that was what the Bereans did. They searched the scriptures, not when they like, when they feel like. They search it daily. Someone was saying, no, I get tired at times. No, even when you're tired. Because the purpose of that tiredness is for you not to study. Mm. Yeah, try and study. After all, God gave you life. Mm. Amen?
Amen.
Coming to church will not be a burden. No. It's ignorance that's affecting many people. Because they think that on a Sunday, I can just sleep. No. If I just discover that the more you, the older you become, the less sleep you can sleep.
That's true. Yes.
Because I slept at about 12 or so. Yeah, I think about 12. Yes, about 12. And by 4 o'clock, I'm already yawning. I tried to sleep again, 5 o'clock, and then I couldn't sleep. I was just thinking about today. I see everybody. I just think, I said, God will not allow me to sleep now. I can't even say, I said, I want to put in one more hour. I said, no. So I just stood up 5 o'clock. Amen?
Amen.
I stood up at about, I tried again. And then I think I finally woke up just between 5 and 6 or so. Yeah. But before 6 o'clock. Amen.
Amen.
So please. All these things are important for us. When we begin to walk with God, they begin to reveal certain things for us. What would have happened if Sister Jenny had not picked it up in the realm of the Spirit to pray for her brother? It was the only one, and we know even some garden fences were blown away by that storm. Yes. Doris. Yeah. Even some people were struggling. I was watching the TV. Even the reporter was struggling because she could be blown away. How much more? Him alone was on the Atlantic Ocean. Yes. Without any coordinate. But God.
Coordinator.
Second Chronicles 16:9. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro across the whole earth. Praise God.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
John chapter 5, verse 39. You search and investigate and pore over the scriptures diligently because you suppose and trust that you have eternal life through them. And these very scriptures testify about me. Here Jesus was pointing people to the scriptures which testifies about him. The scripture will give you life. And that is why we pour over it. We don't just glance. We pour over it. If it matters to you, it matters to God. Pour over it and discover, what does God want me to do? Should I use contraception for my young ones? No. Should I allow them to be living in partners when they are not married? No. The scripture points people to Jesus. That is why we need to memorize it and know it by heart. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I may not sin against you. 119, Psalms, verse 11. The word of God kept in our heart will stop us from sin. The word have I treasured in my heart, the New American Standard Bible. Have I treasured in my heart? Is the word of God a treasure for you? Remember, he said, where your heart is, that's where your treasure is. And where your treasure is, that's where your heart is. So if the word of God is your treasure, your heart will be in God's word. When devil come, in the name of Jesus, you know you don't have the Bible, but the Bible is in your heart.
Amen.
Your word have I laid up in my heart. After fire, I said, you must lay it up, store it up, archive it in your heart. A treasure is something you are proud of, a must have. Is the scripture a treasure for you? Now you can judge how much of God that is in you. Matthew 13, verse 44. Are you still with me?
Yes.
Matthew 13, verse 44, please, to 46. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and hid, and for joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who, when he had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it. Is the word of God your treasure? It is your treasure. You will protect it. You see, some people come to church, but in the church, they belong to satanic cults. They belong to cults, because every cult is satanic anyway. So what's the point of them coming to church? And this is because they have not seen the word of God as a treasure. Those guys that are in the, you know, just making laws over us. And making satanic laws. You know, they're just doing the work of their father. The fact their father is not God. Because if their father is God, they will not be saying that marriage is between a man and a man. If their father is God, they will not be telling us to join people that are of the same sex in civil partnership. Where is it written in the Bible? But you don't need to fight anyone. Just hold on to the word of God.
Amen.
Things are going to get worse. But in the midst of the chaos, God will come back for his
church. Amen.
This is what all scripture does for anyone who has understanding. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. Romans 1:16. For it is the power of God for salvation, for anyone that believes. God is not begging people to believe. But if you believe, the gospel, which is the scripture, will benefit you. All scripture is what? Profitable. That means that it profits people, especially those that believe it. I, Daniel, understood by the books. The scripture is not a trade-off with something else. It is not it's not something that is exchangeable or replaceable. I understood by the books. If Daniel gained understanding from the scriptures, the plan of God for Jerusalem, how much more can you understand from the scriptures God's plan for your life? Hello?
Hi.
Doesn't that make sense? Yes. Luke 24, verse 44 to 45, please. That all things must be fulfilled which were written in the law of Moses and the prophet and the Psalms concerning me. And it opened their understanding that they might comprehend the scriptures. Can you see that? It opened their understanding that they might comprehend the scriptures. But they have been following him. But he now opens their understanding that they might comprehend the scripture. If their understanding was not closed, why was it then opened? It could not have been opened unless it was first closed. So that's why some people will hear, and yet they will still not understand. They have ears, but they cannot hear. They have eyes, but they cannot see. And it's not that they are blind physically, but they are blind spiritually. May the Lord open your understanding.
Amen.
That should be our prayer, isn't it?
Yes.
May the Lord open my understanding so that I can comprehend the scriptures.
Amen.
These people followed him for 3.5 years. Yet some of them followed him with blank minds. Can you imagine? Then he now opened their minds to understand the scriptures. Amplified verse 45 says, then he thoroughly opened up their minds to understand the scriptures. Until you pray to God to thoroughly open your mind to the scriptures, you may be coming to church, but you do not see the need for it. You know, it's possible to be coming to church and still not see the need. Yeah, because something is blocked. Understanding needs to be open. Say, I was glad when they said to me,
let us go to
the house of the Lord. Why was he glad? Because he knows the house of the Lord is the place of blessing.
Amen.
Why would the house of God be a house of mourning for some people? I don't understand. All scripture. Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 4. Where the word of a king is, there is power. And who may say to him, what are you doing? If the word of the king has power, much more power is therefore with the word of God. All scripture. Peter and John said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rise up and walk. And he took him by the hand, right hand, Acts chapter 3, verse 7, and lifted him up, and immediately strength came to his feet and ankle. Listen. Not until the heart of a man was opened. Not until the heart of that man was opened, he could not receive the power of God to heal him. So Peter said to him, look at us. Verse 5. So he gave them his attention. So all along, where was his attention? Somewhere else. And that's what happens at times. You might be in the church, but your mind is somewhere else. And that's how the Holy Spirit could not help us, even though we're in the midst of God. See? So he gave them his attention, because all along his attention was not on Peter and John. He was looking at them, but his attention, his mind, was not on Peter or John. He was expecting to receive something from them. So you might need to rule over your mind, so that your mind is in God's word. So that coming to church will not be a burden. It's a place of blessing. Studying the Bible at home should not be a burden. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You might be praying to God, but your mind is not on God or in something else. So close to God, but far. So close, but far. Verse 9. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. Somebody is going to walk. Somebody is going to praise God.
Amen.
Somebody is going to rejoice.
Amen.
Then they knew that it was he who sat begging. You see, your story will not be completed without the shame that you suffered. Because God will turn that shame around to faith.
Amen.
So don't forget that whatever you are going through, as shameful as it might be, God has a hand in it. Amen.
Amen.
And they were filled with wonders and amazement at what had happened to him. You too be filled with wonders and amazement.
Amen.
The entrance of your world gives light, it gives understanding to the simple. Psalm 119 verse 130. The simple ones are the believing ones. The simple ones are the ones genuinely interested in the word of God. It is then that the scriptures shed light into their heart. I believe I should bring this to a close. Isaiah 55, verse 10 to 11. Isaiah 55, verse 10 to 11. For as the rain comes down and snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth and make it bring forth and grow, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Next verse. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. See, capital M, that refers to who?
God.
So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please. Who is in control?
God.
The devil is not in control. No. Turn somebody and say, the devil is not in control of my life. God is. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please.
Amen.
And it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. All scripture. And lastly, 2 Timothy 3:16. All scripture is given by the inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. So all scripture is given. All scripture is by inspiration of God. All scripture is profitable. All scripture is for doctrine, that is principles of life. Then we know that it's not right for a man that is not married to a woman to be living together. Where do we come out with all these principles from? The doctrine, the scripture. All scripture is for reproof. That's why they can tell you off from the scripture. Even if it's a man of God or a bishop, why would a bishop have another girlfriend? You tell him off. Why would a bishop exchange his wife for another wife? You tell him off. Did you see that? Did Jesus Christ ever do that?
No.
You call yourself a bishop. It could be any member of the church. If you are living together with somebody else that you're not married to, you are not married to, rather, they will reprove you, isn't it? Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's for correction, to bring you back on track. Say back on track.
Back on track.
And it's for instruction. As you see me, if I do anything wrong, you can correct me.
Yes, sir.
From the word of God. And I give you opportunity to do that.
Yes.
From the word of God. And so also I can correct you when you do something wrong. From the word of God.
Amen.
What do they say now? All right, whatever you do for the peace is also for the exactly. It's for instruction. Verse 17, please. Last one. Why? This scripture. That the man of God and the woman of God may be complete. Everyone say complete.
Complete.
Thoroughly furnished. And equipped. Thoroughly equipped, brother. For every good work. It's for you to do good work. Amen.
Amen.
All scripture. Father, we thank you. We bless you. Can you just talk to God that God open my heart, that I may understand the scriptures. Open my mind, that I may understand the scriptures. Lord, open my whole being to understand the scriptures, so that I will know your plan for me. Let that young woman pray. Let that young man pray. Because when I was young, I prayed to God, Lord, I don't want to marry a wrong woman. I want you, oh God, to give me the right woman for me. And he did. You too can pray. Lord, I want to do very well in my GCSC. Lord, I want to do very well in the university. Lord, I want to be a doctor. I want to be an accountant. Lord, I want to be an astronaut. I want to just, it's a good thing. And God will preserve the lives of your parents to see you through. It doesn't matter whether you're a lone parent or not. God is in the house. This is what God said we should do. God told Abraham in Genesis 18:19, I know my servant Abraham. He will correct his children. He will teach his children the way of God. Is that you God is vouching for? Come on, pray that God open my mind to understand the scripture. Open my mind to understand the scripture. Open the minds of my wife. Open the mind of my husband. Open the mind of my the minds of my children to understand the scriptures. Open the minds of members of Church of the Rock to understand the scriptures. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Come on, keep those hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Amen.
Amen.
Are your eyes open?
Yes.
Yes. I think that should be a daily prayer. You know, the more we know Him, the more we want to know Him.
Oh, yes.
We can never get too much of God.
Oh, yes.
Amen.